we board this EasyJet aeroplane from Stansted to Naples.
We spend 12 nights at the Hotel Al Sogno. Apparently Al Sogno is the name for Italy before Roman times. The entrance is not particularly inspiring through these gates, which are normally closed and you have to press a doorbell to get to open a small gate. But it gets a little bit better as you get inside. On entering the front gate, you can come into this courtyard, which could be very nice if it wasn't so jam-packed with parked cars. A few tables and chairs and some nice palm trees would be very nice. Here's the entrance to the hotel, and there is a lift that takes you up to the various floors. This lift, really, one shouldn't look too closely at. We're on the second floor, and the hotel has been fitted out in a nautical theme. Everything you see, all the lights, the fittings, all have a nautical theme to it. There's a map of the world, old map of the world. A cabinet with various nautical items in there. We're in room 31. It's a bit like walking down a passageway, what I imagine would look like walking down a passageway of a submarine. Is our room. It's in a fairly quiet opening. And Heidi in the bathroom, just washing the cherries. Even the wardrobe has got a nautical touch to it. And on the wall, we have a collection of these knots on display. One or two I recognise from fishing, but a lot of them are strange to me. Very nicely displayed. This is an aerial view of Herculaneum. This is the baths, or the men's baths, changing and waiting area. These are the men's baths. This is the female changing and waiting area. Well, the lady's got some mosaics. Perhaps the men did too and they're no longer here. Oh, and here's one lady waiting for a bath. lovely mosaic.
Our trip across the Bay of Naples takes us to Ischia. And here at Ischia, we see the most famous landmark called fungo, or mushroom.
This is a view of Sant'Angelo on the south side of the island. Heidi and the port of Ischia. Thank you. Well, this is Heidi on top of Vesuvius. It's Pompeii down there. The Bay of Naples. Sorrento Peninsula. Capri there in the background. Mediterranean Sea. Various islands. And Naples itself. This is the inner courtyard of the Royal Palace. It's not such a fantastic building from this angle or from the outside, but inside it has 20 odd rooms of absolute splendour and a magnificent staircase.
Here we are inside the gallery Umberto I, a beautiful building with expensive shops and a lovely ceramic and mosaic floor. This is the view of the very fine looking Castel Nuovo.
Busy port of Naples.
Positano.
The Naples underground train. This is Pompeii.
Pompeii was engulfed by an eruption of Vesuvius in 79 AD, and as a result it's not suffered the pillaging and the damaging by weather that other sites have had to put up with. So therefore it is very well preserved.
This is called the Park Orchard. with almonds, quince, grapes, and a variety of other goodies that the people grew for themselves. One of the dogs of Pompeii. Back in Naples.
We spend a day on the Isle of Capri.
It's a view of the port and the Capri Marina, Capri town, and the Sorrento Peninsula.
Here we see the gardens of San Michele.
There are some people entering the Blue Grotto. Oh, duck before you go in.
A Detroit, avete una buona ganancia. Che paghi prezzo? Ok, allora for the...
Yeah, but not when we go in here.
Va bene, vai, Sento più, faccio il scendere.
Thank you. Pronto, buonasera, io sono Nicolò, posso parlare con qualcun coreano? Grazie.
And now on the way down. This is Piazza Umberto in the town of Capri. Is that an R3?
No.
Acton in Naples. It's nice to know these little 500 bone shakers are still on the road. Here's a view from the Castel d'Ovo. Another little marina. And what looks like probably the best hotels. Julius Caesar in the Archaeological Museum of Naples. What a fine mosaic from Pompeii, which is described as actors getting ready for a performance under the instruction of the choreographer.
Sadly, our trip to Naples and its fascinating surroundings has to come to an end.